All right, Jim, our final question this week, sent to CornyDriveThru at gmail.com from Darren Walker in London. What are Jim's views on Doink the Clown, the character? I thought the heel Doink was brilliant and well played by Matt Borne. Also, any stories about Matt Borne as well?
Oh, good Lord. I get the appeal of Doink the Clown the way that Matt Borne did it. I wouldn't have ever done it if it had been me. Because and it got really silly. Matt Borne was a dark, demented individual, and so he was able to bring that creativity and that part into the thing. But all it was from the WWF side was, oh, we've got an evil clown. The visual was ridiculous. The Doink music, when they had the midget clown, the dink, and the fucking little dinkettes and all that shit. Matt Borne did a great job with it, and it's one of those things that you, and also he could work, but it's one of those things that you have to be there from the start, having been watching the TV, understanding how it developed, and understanding why he's there, because it's one of those things that when you just had it on your show and somebody new tuned in or didn't know what was going on or didn't understand it, the visual was just fucking stupid. A fucking wrestling clown and the fucking horn honking and the noise making and all the noise. It was like a goddamn Dr. Seuss nightmare on acid come to life. And then when he was gone and they had other, it just got really just stupid and silly. So, you know, I'm not a big fan of wrestling clowns. Imagine that.
Is there anyone else you think would have been good in that role other than Matt Borne?
You know, that's the first time I've ever been asked that question. If I would recast the role of Doink the Clown.
The original Doink, when eventually, whatever, Phil Apollo did it, it was a complete baby face. There was nothing of any value in that character. But when he was the heel Doink, there was a demonic mystery to the guy.
Yeah, yeah.
And Borne played it well. Ray Apollo, excuse me.
Yeah, Ray Apollo just wanted a check, and he's a nice guy, and he knew he lucked into a spot there, and he was just going to be the wacky clown, because he didn't give a fuck. He's getting paid. But, yeah, Matt Borne was the kind of weirdo that would fucking put all the mental things and the twistedness and the darkness into it. And, you know, it might have been best for him, maybe. Who knows? Maybe that was the crowning achievement of his in-ring career. Because his other contribution was if he'd have kept his dick in his pants, there'd have been no Road Warriors. So there's always that. So Matt Borne did do good things for Arn Anderson was not a fucking fan till the land. And also didn't
Jim
Borne
Duggan wasn't a fan.
Shoot on Jim Duggan for some fucking reason.
It may have been mutual shooting in that case. Because the story was they had a lot of problems. That's why they broke up the Rat Pack in Mid-South. Duggan had a lot of problems with Matt Borne. There was a locker room fight at one point. That's the one with the famous story that Tony Atlas told where he was working there. And Ernie Ladd was separating Borne and Duggan. And Ernie's knees were giving out. So he's like sinking to the ground. He's like, Tony Atlas, keep these men away from each other. That's Ernie's going down.
He slowly sinks into. Well, all I know is if Jim Duggan and Matt Borne had a problem, who wins the prize of being the asshole in that situation had to be Matt Borne. Is all I'm going to say. Okay, if anybody could have a problem with Hacksaw. But yeah, so he's famous for being the world's wrestling's best evil clown, and if it wasn't for his sexual practices, there'd be no Road Warriors. And a great dressing room fight involving Ernie Ladd. That's what Matt Borne's noted for.